This is the BDC, and we have spotted an ex-vegan on the Thailand beach.
I wonder if I have scurvy. I could have scurvy. It feels like it, just intuitively. I'm like, these are weird pains.
There's the vegetable police now. And this is Gary. I'm the vegan carburetor here on YouTube. And we're getting ready for a big Thursday. Thursdays are always big. There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on. So, got my fruit shirt. A lot of citrus going on there. Got a melon behind me. And this, I'm going to try to bring all this to you, even though I just don't have enough time in the day or in the week. But I'm going to do my best here. I'm prepared. I'm prepared. Thursdays are always big. Notice that. Outside of the vegetable police world, but definitely within, I've noticed a pattern here, and something big always happens on Thursdays. And I'm about to bring it to you. This is Gary's Morning Report.
Chimps are going ape, giraffes remain above it all. Elephants remember, though just what I can't recall. Crocodiles are snapping up fresh offers from the banks. Showed interest in my nest egg, but I quickly said, no thanks. We haven't paid the hornbills, and the vultures have a hunch. Not everyone invited will be coming back from lunch. This is the Morning Report.
Not a tale I distort.
On the Morning Report. What are you doing,
son? We're going to cover this vegetable police video from the top. Here we go.
I'd do it as soon as I got down here. I wanted to do a water fest. I said I would do it as soon as I got down here. Now I've explored the territory enough to where I know I can get some food if I need it. I know where everything is for the most part. I got access to the ocean. We're gonna do it. I'm hoping for 10 days. I don't want to go too overboard. The longest...
How did you notice he seems to be... Excited. I'm just excited. You're not supposed to be excited about fasting. But he seems a little too excited about the idea of doing it. And we're gonna get another hint as to why that would be, because that sounds like a mania to me. And he it doesn't seem, from this video here, that he needs to do a water fast. You know, he just did a beef cleanse. This like 8 weeks? Well, maybe not 8 weeks, you know. There's some debate about that timeline.
This water fast I've ever done was 5 days. And we try to beat that? And let's see, I just want the challenge.
Now see right there. Yeah. For some reason, he thinks of these things as a challenge, and that creates an excitement. Also, he wants to beat his record. So this isn't about just being doing something healthy, trying to fix something. You know, he's made a game out of it. Yeah. And that's not healthy.
Let's flush out some of this disgusting weird shit inside my body.
Okay. Okay, he mentions there that he says he's got a lot of weird stuff. A lot of crap inside his body. Well, why would that be? Because, you know, he just did a beef cleanse. Oh. Okay, I think I figured it out. Let's continue.
He's walking somewhere.
Sorry about the wind. Hopefully we're all good. Maybe. What the hell? It's a wig monster. And why I'm gonna fast. So let's talk about it. I love coming to the beach to get away from all the scooters. I just, like, this is the place where I want to escape it. So for the most part, I'm
That's pretty good, pretty good. I know, me and him are the ones in this community with the most sense of humor. And I really enjoy his humor, and I thought he'd think that I was funny too, but for some reason he doesn't. It's weird. And here I'm noticing his sense of humor is different than mine. He comes up with stuff I wouldn't have thought of doing. Okay, continuing.
Feeling good, I might have scurvy. I might have that. I've just been noticing some weird pains in my spine, in my elbow, and it's just like, it's not workout pains, it's like scurvy pirate pains. It's like, is it possible? It might be possible. So, I had a bit of papaya the other
day. Okay, hold on here. It's interesting that he knows what scurvy is like. Is that the case there? And I also noticed that he's got all these issues going on, but he doesn't get this stuff verified on what it is. You know, he can do that with a blood test. Yeah, you could. Okay. Let's see what he's saying here about papaya.
It might be possible. So, I had a bit of papaya the other day, just as a test, and I do believe the symptoms lessened slightly. So, I did order some vitamin C, but it's a real issue, this carnivore thing, trying to protect you from the wind. That vitamin C scurvy shit. I don't know. It's weird, but my skin clears up, my energy is good, digestion's interesting, hair.
All this from vitamin C? So, carnivore, you know, vegan goes ex-vegan, goes carnivore, gets vitamin C deficiency, of course. You know, could have taken supplement. But, you know, the carnivores on the YouTube there, they don't talk about taking vitamin C or anything like that. So, they talk about it being natural. You're not supposed to take any supplements because of that. So he has a couple bites of papaya or something. Maybe a whole one. maybe he just blocked that out of his memory there. But he had some papaya and then started feeling good? Really? Really? So fruit, like I've been teaching over here, is the magic food. I've said that. I'm trying to teach people that people don't eat enough fruit. That's the big food. And it's got magic power.
makes you feel much better. As you close the door of dreams, a little magic power makes it better than it seems.
Don't want to get flagged there. We can only go like 30 seconds playing a song. You know. Okay, back to Melonhead.
So sick right now. I don't know what happened.
None of us know what happened. Okay, there's a little bit in here. I don't want to show you. Let's see what it is.
Life is good. I tried eggs out. They constipate me. Meat is fine. Eggs, terrible.
Huh? Okay, that's strange. What do you make of that one? None of them have fiber in them. What's the difference between eggs and meat? There's no difference. No fiber. Moderately high in protein, maybe. No carb. No, none of that carb stuff. Carb stuff. And high in fat. And cholesterol. Don't forget it. Very important. You know, we're made out of cholesterol. Well, sort of. Anyway, no difference. No difference. So maybe it's in his head. I don't know. How much is in his head here? He talked about that recently. Yeah, I think this week he talked about, well, the psychosomatics here. He might be just feeling good because, I don't know. Maybe because he's just suddenly run into a lot of money. And he doesn't actually have problems. I don't know.
So we're learning. We're learning what I can eat.
Are we learning? Are we learning something? I'm just trying to put stuff out there, and everybody will learn something different. Based on your own life experience.
And what I can't, I ate papaya and grapes a little bit. I didn't get itchy or anything. I didn't love the feeling of fiber in my gut, though. It was just slightly painful. I'm like, I'm used to having nothing in there. So, it's interesting, though. I think those are low histamine fruits or something. I'm not...
Where does the meat go? Well, I did skip over a lot of that bathroom talk, so, but the meat's in there, and it doesn't feel good. Our intestines are made for fiber, and there's no doubt about that.
Not reacting to whatever's in that, so that's a plus, and I just... There's a couple negatives. I said I wouldn't talk about this, but I have to. I can't stop it. I feel pretty disgusted by the diet. I'm just getting sick of the meats. It's so rich and fatty, and I'm just...
Yep. I predicted this, I think recently. Talked about it before, that... Yeah, how can you... And why? Why just one food? And not just one food, but not just one food group, but just beef all the time. I've talked about mono dieting and why it's not a good idea, because your palate will get tired of it. I've discovered that People call that palate burnout. And when that happens, well, you're just not going to eat as much as you would on a more varied diet. And so you're restricting yourself when you do that. And you're just going to get tired of it. And I've wondered how long it was going to take for him to get tired of, you know, fatty foods. I've eaten enough fat to get tired of one meal. I had a rare fat meal the other day, a couple nights ago, sunflower seeds. And then, you know, half a cup, I started getting sick of it. But I like sunflower seeds, so. Okay, we'll continue here.
It's so rich and fatty, and I'm just like, oh, God.
Yeah, any food, I've thought of this at least, that any food, no matter how much you like it, if you eat enough of it, and maybe just eat that food, you will get tired of it. You'll start to get kind of nauseated.
I'm so often nauseous, almost every day for at least a few hours. I'm like, oh, God. Today was the worst. I had just eggs and mayonnaise. Eggs and mayonnaise. That was my meal. It's like 1,700 calories, and I was absolutely stuffed and just nauseous.
I wonder how many eggs you ate.
100 calories, and I was absolutely stuffed in mayonnaise. 2 hours. Almost.
I think it's just my lame boiled egg, boiled meats. Meats, what else in here? There's something in here.
Worse, I had just eggs and mayonnaise.
He's so vegetarian right now. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, he's right about that. He didn't eat any meat that day, so he's vegetarian. Oh. Of course, that's debatable, though.
Eggs and mayonnaise. That was my meal. It's like 1,700 calories, and I was absolutely stuffed and just not.
So isn't eggs about 100 calories? So without the mayonnaise, that would have been 17 eggs. What exactly is he thinking here? Well, how is that any different from the beef cleanse?
What am I doing with my life? So it's kind of disgusting, I will admit it. I would love to be able to eat some fruits and other things. So I just want to stop for a bit and listen to my body and see what it's calling for. I gotta stop distracting myself with YouTube and trying to learn intellectually. I need to go within more and come out here more and listen to the answers. I hope any of this audio is usable. That's gonna suck. These waves are so powerful.
Now, if I were out there with my camera, you wouldn't be able to hear much of what I had to say, because he's got the expensive equipment, and you've all been paying for it. By the way, I have the Patreon account. It's just sitting there waiting.
They're not usually like this. I'll go out there soon. So, let's go now. I come here twice a day, usually right in the morning. And now, it's like maybe 5 p.m.
All right. Have you noticed that up to this point? Probably noticed. But 5 p.m.?
But I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm paranoid of the jellyfish.
He's out there on a beach. He's outside. He's on a beach. And there's no sign of any other person. That's right. He doesn't say in his video that he just got a private beach. It just looks like it. And it's a good one. White sands and clear water. What the heck is going on?
I see them all the time. I almost walk into them every time. Like, that could be one.
Okay, believe it or not, we've reached the part where he's no longer talking about diet. 4.5 minutes. So he spends the rest of this video, another 8 minutes, talking about random stuff like jellyfish. I can't even recall what else. So that means it probably won't be very interesting to you either. But I have something else. Yes, yes, there's more things going on this Thursday. I'll start with myself. Yeah. More on diet. Now, I gotta be comfortable here. I can't get comfortable here. Now, I've been trying to eat more so I can do the intermittent fasting again. And neither one is going well. There was a couple good days where it's getting close to 2,000 calories. It felt pretty good too. My digestion is pretty good. And there was one day where I got in a good weightlifting. I'm making more time for that now. And that allowed me to sleep better. 9 hours, maybe? Yeah, that felt pretty good. But now, I've lost sleep again. But I'm going to get this. I have been feeling better, though. And, yeah, my life's gotten a little easier. So I guess that's it for that segment of my video. God, I feel the strength. I did until today. I'm kind of weak today. I don't know. I don't understand that. So, I want to show you some other stuff going on here. Oh yeah, Rob Stewart made a video about him just a couple days ago. And let's see. Did Better Police inspire this Rob Stewart to quit veganism and promote keto diet? And, yeah, a few hours earlier I had posted a comment on his video about quitting. One of those comments got a like. Congratulations, your comment got a heart from Rob Stewart. He liked one of my posts. Let's go and see. Rob Stewart guy. See what that comment is. I'll be making another video about this guy. There was so much to cover. Rod. Come on. Really? There he is.
So people ask me all the time.
Let's see what he's doing these days. Phase 3 of, I don't know. Oh, I haven't seen this video yet. Gonna do that. Okay, here's the video.
Probiotics are the hottest new health.
Okay, the comment he learned. Let's see. There I am. Wow. There's the heart from him. See, there you go. I said, sigh. He loved that I sighed at his video. I'll be doing a response to this again. Oh, that's what he loved. Yeah, he's loving the attention here. He's loving the thumbs down. A lot of thumbs down, of course. And, but that doesn't stop your views. Nope, it doesn't. See, there's a comment about vegetable please here. Tim Shays and now Rob. Lots of vegans coming out. Yep, coming out of the closet. It's about how it's feeling them. Respect the honesty. There you are. I was talking about this, I think in my last video. Yeah, people think the vegetable police is so honest because he's criticizing the vegan diet he was on. And so that makes you appear honest. Because you're going against, you're selling out. So honest. Honestly. Well, you know, this guy is probably just an anti-vegan who wants to make it look like veganism's not good, and that's how you do it, propaganda there. And notice his last name is Bush. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this again. I appreciate your sincerity. I made a 25-minute video. Just preliminary on this guy. And it's basically the message was that it really appears that he's not being sincere. There's too many red flags. And I was just getting started on that 25-minute preliminary video. I appreciate your sincerity. After 2 years watching all your videos. I think I left a comment for that guy. Let's see if I can find that. No, yeah, maybe. Morning report, people. At least 3 times a week, I've been given this morning report. This Murphy guy, man. What's he on about? Someone needs to read the science. Keto diet is the worst for long-term health. It's just BS. When you're a YouTuber, and you start to realize, yeah, I've seen this comment. This is a good one. Right here is the message of my video. And you start to realize it's getting harder to gain fame off the vegan lifestyle. There was a point when vegan videos, when people were flocking to them because that was the in thing. But things don't stay in. At some point, when people have done something for a while, it's no longer new and exciting. And then you need to, and then comes the next new and exciting thing. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's that picture. Another picture here. Vegan Senator Cory Booker. Sign the petition that vegan senator made and demand the Senate vote no to Brett Kavanaugh lifetime appointment to the Supreme Court. This guy's not even a true American. He doesn't believe in the Constitution or that, you know, checks and balances even. He wants to force women to give birth to unwanted kids who grow up to suffer and eat animals that have suffered their whole life. But enough about that. I don't really want to get into any more of that hearing stuff. So let's move on to the next thing here. Yeah, I had a good comment here a couple days ago. I was talking to this guy. Yeah, I was talking to, let's see. There was some quote he made that said that, well, I guess he was talking about diabetes, and it collaborates to the reduction of fat in people's diet. Wait. Or maybe getting rid. Wait. Oh, diabetes. He's saying diabetes is actually caused by the fact that people reduce their fat in the 80s and 90s, you know, that lie that I've debunked before. And so I went looking for his information because I'm well versed in this debate, and I know how it goes. He said, "You sound smart for a meathead." So I hit. No, I'm neither one. He's the meathead. Go back to school. And I had a pretty good comment I want to show you. Ivan, I don't eat soy or meat. Also, I am school. I school people like you for a living. I'm 49 and hovering way above colleges and doctors who play dietitians. You want to dodge all that, and when you get out of your matrix and become as powerful as I, you won't need to dodge doctors. Well, there's one more thing I wanted to show you. One more thing. This is your bonus material for this video. Stay tuned. Okay. Let's see if I can find it here. Let's see.